The video generation is in progress. Total of 408 steps. And 2 seconds for every iteration. With the VRAM consumption around 7 GB. Let's look at the project, Stable Animator. As we can look at the demo, the results are good. The project is good at following the body poses, maintaining the face and hands better than other open source project right now. I tried setting up the application on my computer, and there are few results in the output folder of the project. This was a mistake by me. The movements are slow because there are only 8 frames a second. Let me see another. This had 16 frames in a second. This was the shortest. This was generated after a few corrections. There are minor issues, which can be ignored or corrected by keeping the subject simple. The face and hands are maintained very well. The video generation took around 7 GB of graphic memory for this. 7 GB for a video is good compared to the other projects I have used in the past for generating video. An AI influencer can be made in motion, with just a single image and few video frames from a video. I made a decent amount of video to understand, and experimented how it works, for a better results. You may have bad results if you are having different resolutions. There are 2 things needed, a video with character in motion, and an image of your character. Try matching the resolution of the video and the image, or at least keep it somewhere near. Also, if the video has a full body motion, then the character should also have a full body in the image. I am in my temporary directory to set up the project. But before I start, I want to share that I got my very first channel member. A huge thank you for joining and making this video possible. For installation, open the command prompt. The Python version I have is 3.10.11. And Git installed to get the project in the computer. I will share the project link in the description. Copy the project address. Type the clone command to clone the project. Get inside the project folder by change directory command. Next, create a Python environment to include all the necessary utilities for the project. Activate the environment. I will be giving this command in the description section of the video. We are in the environment. Scroll down and get to the environment setup. This section of the project, we will use these 2 commands first. You can paste both the command together. My computer has problem due to Tiny 11 operating system issues. This command will get the torch necessary to run the project. This will take time. I will run the second command for the XFormer setup. Now, we need to install all the packages from the requirement file. But before that, there is an optional package I wanted to include in the requirement file. Get into the project folder. Open the requirement file in a notepad. This is optional, but it affects the performance. This is the project I was experimenting yesterday. I will copy from here. So I have added the package at the end of all the packages and saved the requirement file. Copy the installation command. Paste the command and press enter. This installation will take some time. Next, we need to download some models mentioned in this section. We are already inside the project, so start with the second command. Install LFS to get large files. Copy this clone command to have all the files from Hugging Face. This will download large files. It took 25 minutes on my computer. Once done, minimize the command prompt and scroll down. This is how the project folder and file structure should be after the download. If you check the project folder, everything downloaded from Hugging Face just now is in the checkpoint folder. Inside you will also find a models folder. Move the folder and its content outside of the checkpoint folder. Everything should match as shown in the left. If you scroll down, there is an error mentioned here. I don't think you will get this error now. Copy this make directory command. This command will make a folder named inference. It's not compulsory to make a folder with the command. You can do it the normal way using right-click. This is the folder structure you need to maintain inside the inference folder. The content to keep inside the inference folder can be found here, in the OneDrive link. These are the folders you have to keep inside the inference folder. You can select the folders to be downloaded. I suggest getting all the folders. In this example, I will select only two folders because the download is extremely slow. I have all the folders in the older project setup. Keep the content in the project, then inside inference folder. The 80 megabytes file took an hour to download. Once downloaded, go to the download location and extract the file in the inference folder. After extracting, you should have all 15 folders. I have two in this example. Move this case files and keep it directly inside the inference folder. This is my older project setup from yesterday. I will copy all the files so it looks the same as yours. You can delete the downloaded files. We don't need that. We are done with the setup. We can run the application now. You can scroll down to copy or type the command python spaceapp.py. There will be some small files. Starts downloading when running for the first time. My 16 gigabytes of RAM goes 100% while starting. The program is running. If you scroll down, you will see some demo images with their resolution. Look at this column, Driven Poses. It has the folder path into inference. It's the same thing downloaded from OneDrive. This FPS here, if you remember, at the beginning showed a slow motion video. It was due to this 8 FPS. Width and height should match with the image. I'm still not done with all the settings, but I will explain how it works. This driven poses loaded from the demo is pointing at the folder we downloaded from OneDrive. I will click the generate video and have a result quickly. This quick example has 20 steps, around 5 seconds for each step. Time taken was slightly more than 2 minutes. This application has a small problem. The result is not visible here. When you see starting saving the frames, then you should check inside the project. You should find the video there. I could have fixed this, but making video was a priority. Maybe I will make a fork of this project with the fix. You can see we made a 2-second video just by using an image. But where did the dancing motion came from if we haven't given a prompt? This driven poses directory is where the motion was generated from. If we look inside the project, inference folder, then case 5 folder, you will find poses. Inside there are these black images. These images are what their name says, frames. Starting from 0 to 15, there are total 16 frame with skeleton motion. All of these images are made out of a video frame, which has been converted into the skeleton. Frame 1 is the follow-up of 0 in poses. All these poses are follow-up of the previous pose, used to generate a smooth animation. If I just copy this 15 poses in a different folder and rename the frame, as this is a follow-up after the 15th frame, my new folder inside poses has 16 frames, named sequentially after the original frames. I will copy this from 16 till 31 and keep next to the original frames. Now, case 5 has total 32 frames starting from 0 to 31. There is this one more folder named faces. It contains the position of the face in the skeleton we saw in poses folder. Even this needs to be duplicated to make it work. In a similar manner, I copied, renamed, and pasted back. Now, there are a total of 32 faces in this folder. The 2-second video from 16 poses should be a 4-second video. Letting all the settings as it is, I clicked Generate. Total of 60 steps with 5 seconds for each. After 5 minutes, I got the result. This is a 4-second video. I'm not saying this is the best, but I was just trying to show a small example. I hope you got the requirements, faces, and poses. The 15 cases downloaded from OneDrive and kept in the inference has 15 motions. Upload a similar size image and change the poses directory by case number, then click Generate. Image and motion can be made from those 15 cases. But how about adding your own motions? I searched for solo dancing clips. A full body clip with the character in the center should work. A thanks by donation, I would like to, but I haven't received any payment from YouTube yet. I should, after my first payment. My recorder became unresponsive. I searched for video to frames PNG. I'm expecting to get the video frames from here. I made a new folder named case-17. After the upload, I selected the start and end time of the video for the frame to be exported. I decreased the frame size because processing larger images may take more hardware. I took 5 frames from every second because the video has too many frames. Click Convert to PNG. You should be able to check the PNG if you scroll down. Click Download Frame as ZIP. Once downloaded, extract the frames in the case folder you have created. These are the images we got from the video. Now remember, we need skeleton and locate the face in the skeleton. To make a skeleton, we need to rename all the image as frame 1, 2, 3, and so on. Renaming this many was a task, so I made a Python script which should do the work. I made a folder rename underscore poses. Then I made a Python file rename underscore poses. You can do it by copy-pasting an existing Python file and renaming it. Paste all the images into the new folder created. The Python file you created, open using Notepad and delete all the content. This is the script you need to keep in that Python file. To run this program, type python rename underscore poses.py. Then press Enter. This program will rename all the files in that particular folder. Copy the renamed images. Go to inference folder, then the case folder. For me it's case-17. Create folders similar to what other cases have. Faces and poses folder with the reference image of a human. In my case, the reference image will be a full body as per the skeleton. I think this should be my character and reference image. Keep the reference image as PNG image. Create a new folder with name, target underscore images in the case folder. Copy all the images into it. Let poses and faces be empty. Back to the command prompt, I will share this command to create the skeleton. This command is for directory case 16, you need to change the number to whatever number is your folder name. I have changed all the 6 to number 7 for my case. You can have the folder names match in the command. Target images, poses, and reference image. Press enter to run. It should be done in a few seconds. It's done, and you can have a few of the images checked. Next, we need to locate the face in the poses. This is the command to locate the face. Change the case number as per your folder. Press enter to run the program. It took 2 minutes, let's check the folder. There is this one image, I think, face not detected. I can ignore this. Back to the application, we'll upload the image. Change the folder name to get the new poses added. I will keep the FPS 16. Let's generate and check the result. It happens to be 120 steps and 5 seconds for each. In the output folder, the recent created folder should have the result. I should have decreased the FPS, or maybe taken some more frames instead of just 5. I took 8 frames a second from the original video and tried again. The mistake here was, in the original video, the character goes far from the camera. I think, character at a fixed distance should give better results. I need to get the best combination while getting frames. And setting the FPS while generating video. What do you think about this project?